See, in the last class about standards of library automation, we discussed what are the various standards used for library automation, right? So we discussed about ISO standard, ISO 27009 standard in particular. So moving on from that, I want to tell you about another important standard, that is ISA 39.50 protocol, right? I want to tell you what this standard is about and what is the need for this particular standard. Okay, so we will see what this standard is all about. So see, the problem here is, there is a problem. That's why ISA 39.50 protocol has been introduced. So what is the problem? So when you have tried to search information through various databases, one might be in Google Scholar, one might be in Scope, PerceptSCO, or whatever it may be, you had to struggle with learning and using various interfaces across each database, right? So for example, I will tell you this with a simple example. There are different kinds of search engine, right? Like there is Google, there is Yahoo, there is Bing. Okay, there are different kinds of search engine. But if you want to search information on Google, you have to go to Google only. If you want to search information on Yahoo, you have to go again to Yahoo. Okay, so what if you get all the information in a single search? Like you are combining Google, Yahoo, Bing and everything. So similarly, what this ISA 39.50 does is, it enables multiple diverse databases to be searched from same interface. Okay, instead of searching Google, Yahoo and Bing separately for finding results, you can search in a single search, in a single interface. Okay, it is federating everything to provide a single interface to search across multiple platforms, right? So library, there are different kinds of, if you want to know the books available in IIT Madras library and IIT Kharagpur library, you have to go through separate, right? But what this ISA 39.50 does is, it provides a single platform to search across different databases. So that is why this ISA 39.50 protocol is useful. And also, if you don't know how the data is indexed in databases, we studied about indexing, right? So data is indexed in databases, then only you can search. If the data is not indexed, it will not retrieve, right? If you don't know about the indexing procedure, this ISA 39.50 with various profiles can definitely assist you, right? So we will see. So this is the problem. So ISA 39.50 is introduced to solve this particular problem, to search across different databases through a single interface. Okay. So we will see in detail about what this ISA 39.50 and what it does actually and how it helps the libraries. So what is ISA 39.50? It is a computer-to-computer communication protocol designed to support searching and retrieval of information. Simple. It is a protocol. We know what is a protocol, right? TCP IP. Okay, internet protocol. Similarly, protocol is a way to communicate one system to another system. It is a language of the computer in simple terms. Okay, so it is a computer to computer communication protocol. So it communicates with one computer to another computer, right? So ISA 39.50 is nothing but a protocol that communicates from one computer to another computer through a specific set of syntax and rules. Okay, what is the purpose for communication? To support searching and retrieving information. To support search, when someone is searching and you want to retrieve some information, that is the main aim for this communication. So what kind of resources they will search? Full text documents, let it be bibliographical data like author details or something like that, titles, images or multimedia in a distributed network environment. As I told earlier with the search engine example, one might be in Yahoo, one might be in Google or something like that. So in a distributed search environment, you can search in a single interface for all kind of these resources. So what is a protocol? As I already told you, it is a formal set of rules followed for communication between computer devices. You might hear the word protocol in your organization also. This is a protocol. That means if you want to take a leave, you need to give letter to HOD, then you come to the class teacher. That is a protocol. That is a set of rules, nothing but a set of rules for communication between computer and other devices, right? So protocol is similarly, we are having rules in organizations like you should come to class before 9 a.m. These are the protocols, set of rules. Similarly, computer is also having set of rules for communicating with each other. So protocol is nothing but a set of rules. Similarly, EZ39.50 is also a protocol. That means it is having a set of rules for retrieving, for searching and retrieving information. You understand it like that, okay? So EZ39 was assigned by NISO in 1988, okay? National Institute Standard Organization in 1988. I have given all these years and organization because though it is not primarily necessary, but it will be useful for your NET examination. So that's why I have given the organization and all those years and all. All NISO standards start with EZ39. And this was their 50th. So EZ39.50 was their 50th standard. That's why they named it as 50. There is EZ39.82, EZ39.39 and all. So whatever the number it follows, whatever the number of their standard it follows. So EZ39 is the 50th standard. So they named it as EZ39.50. So it is designed, as I said earlier, it is designed to support searching and retrieval. You are searching and getting the information. So this protocol allows a patron to use a computer program called a client. Here patron is the user, okay? Client is a computer program, okay? To submit an information required to multiple data servers without having note how to search on each of the different databases. So see, I gave you an example, like there is Google search engine, Yahoo search engine, and we will say Bing search engine. So there are three different search engines. There are three different search engines, okay? And I am a searcher, I am a user, I am a patron, patron is user. I don't know how to search on this separately. So what I do is, I provide a search on EZ39, okay? I provide a search through a program called client. So I am just typing my query. That is an information request. My query is the information request, okay? Then what the client will do after my request, the client will compile the result based on my search query. The client will compile the research from various three search engines, from Google, Yahoo and Bing, and then retrieve the information back to the patron. Okay. So this is how the searching and retrieval process works. So this is a model of information retrieval. See, this is the client side and this is the server side. This is the client side and this is the server side. So user interface, a patron searches something. Searches means he is typing the keyword in Google, that is searching. So what the EZ39.50 client does, it converts because it is a protocol, right? There is a standard. Your search query is converted into certain rule of codes. There are codes for certain elements according to the language understood by the machine. Or the EZ39.50 converts it. We don't know how it converts because it is everything happening in the back end process. We only typing information and getting results. That's what we know. So all this conversion process and retrieval process is done in the back end. Okay. So EZ39.50 client converts the search query and sends the query to the server. The client, what is that? The search is done and the query is sent to the server. You see, the server it searches the database. What are the database are indexed? See, in our example, Google, Bing and Yahoo, it is indexed. So whatever the results available in Google, Bing and Yahoo, it searches all the three search engine. I am giving an example, that is a database, and it prepares a set of results for that search. Okay, let me say I have typed a search called Public library. I have typed a search called public library. That is my search. Okay. That is my search. Follow my arrow mark carefully. That is my search I have typed. So it goes to the EZ39.50 client and the client sends my search query. Query is nothing but whatever the keyword I typed. Here public library is my query. The query is sent to the server. Okay, what the server does is it searches in the database. What is the database? Here, Google, Bing and Yahoo, the example. Okay, it searches in all the three databases. Okay, databases, and it prepares a set of results based on the search query public library. So results are prepared from all the three databases, and it converts into ISA 39.50, the protocol, right? There is a protocol. ISA 39.50 is nothing but a link language. Okay, link language. It is like a translator, right? For example, I don't know Hindi and you know Hindi, because we need to talk. But someone is translating for both of us. That is what ISA 39.50 is doing. Okay, it is converting, and it is again sent the results. Result set is retrieved by the server, and the records are sent back to the client. Server is retrieved the results from the database, and again it is sending back to the client. The client, after conversion, sends the results back to the user interface. All these things happen in a fraction of a second. We don't know, but this is the ultimate process behind this. So this is a big process. How many things are happening? You are just typing a query in a Google, right? See the back end, how many things are happening. So similarly, ISA 39.50 acts as a communication protocol. It is like a language tool, interlinking language tool to communicate between the client and the server. You remember it like that. And it retrieves the results to the user. So this is the model of resource discovery, right? This is the model of resource discovery. See, it retrieves, these are the resources from various resources like databases, digital libraries, journals, printed books. They collect and store the metadata, that they index the metadata, and they will share the metadata in information retrieval system. There will be more than one system, right? And there will be different kinds of servers, and that all the servers are having a common client. All the servers are having a common client. So the user is searching only using one client. The user is searching using one interface, that is a one client. So how many? See here, three servers are there, three systems are there. You take the example of Google, Yahoo and Bing. Instead of searching separately in Google, Yahoo and Bing, this ISA 39.50 helps you to search all the three in a single platform. So this is the process behind ISA 39.50 of resource discovery. Okay, this image I gave you because for a better understanding. So if you want to obtain information on Yahoo, you have to go again to Yahoo separately. On Google, you have to go to Google, or Bing, you have to go again to Bing, right? Separately. Instead of doing that, ISA 39.50 follows a standard set of protocols, rules that connects all the databases according to the specific rules, and it provides search results according to it. Okay, so we will see how it does that. Okay, so before going into seeing a practical example, we need to understand certain terms like what is client, what is origin, what is target, and what is server. I have told you what is client server, but so we will see that we will understand this term with a specific example. Client handles the user interface. Client is not a person, it is a machine that handles a user interface. Patron is a user. Okay, client is a user interface, that is the interface. What is the interface? Where the user searches, that is the interface. Okay, origin takes information from the client and sends it to the targets across a network. So user is typing a search query like public library, so that is origin. What it does is, so the client receives the user's query, and it takes information, origin takes information from the client, that is a search query, and sends it to the target across a network. So what is the target? Target receives the information from the origin and communicates the search to the database servers. So the target, what is thus is, after receiving information from the origin, see, user has asked for this information about particular library. So origin takes the information and claims and passes it to target. So the role of origin is over there. So now target receives the information. It is like a relay. Target is receiving the information like a baton. And now it communicates with the servers. It communicates with the search to the database server. Okay, now it is saying, so Google, Yahoo, Bing, please search this information for me and send the results. It is asking it, target. So server handles the database search and returns information. So the server, what it does is it searches in different search engines like Google, Yahoo. Yeah, I got your results, man, you take it. Again, it gives the information to the target. So now from the target, client receives again the target, again see the reverse process, target again receive, sends the information to the origin. So origin sends the information to the client. So client receives information from the origin and displays the results for the user, that is in the computer screen. So you are typing a search query in the Google, see how many backend processes are going there, right? Client, origin, target, server, see the terminologies, right? So this is the difference between these terms. So most of the time client and origin are bundled together and the target and server are bundled together. That is true, right? Client and origin are bundled together like a cluster, and target, because target is sending the query to the server and server is returning to the target. Similarly, client origin is taking the information from the client and origin is returning the information to the client. So they are bundled together. The standards speak of specific duties for organization and origin and target. No such languages included for the client and server. So this standard is assigned specific duties. So origin has to perform certain duties and target has to perform certain duties according to certain set of rules. But there is no such rules for server and client, because they are just searching the server is used to search the information, right? So whereas origin and target are used to pass the information. Client is just getting the user query, server is just searching, whereas origin is passing. So when you are passing one information, for example, if I am saying something to Abhilash, Abhilash in Malayalam, he needs to translate it to you in Hindi. Okay, so Abhilash should know Hindi, that is the rule. If Abhilash doesn't know Hindi, means, see, Abhilash is the origin here. I want Abhilash to provide some information to Ritesh in Hindi, because I don't know Hindi. So I am telling him in Malayalam and he wants to translate in Hindi. If Abhilash doesn't know Hindi, means he cannot translate it. So Abhilash here is the origin. Okay, he passes the information from me, from the client, to the target Ritesh. Ritesh is the target. So there is a rule. The rule is Abhilash must know Hindi. So that is why origin and target are having rules and server and client are not having rules. So that is just that standard, that set of rules is what ISA 39.50 defines it. Okay. So when discussing or reading about ISA 39.50, so when someone is talking about ISA 39.50, you need to know what they are talking about, what you are talking about, whether the client or the server, because ISA 39.50 consists of both client as well as server. For example, if a vendor tells you that you are purchasing ISA 39.50, so you are purchasing, sir, purchase ISA 39.50, that means what you are purchasing, client or server or both. That you should know. You should know the difference between client and the server. Unless you don't know it, you cannot assess. Thus, just ISA 39.50 doesn't mean that you are purchasing everything. You can purchase only the client or you can purchase the server. What you are purchasing, that's what you need to know. For example, I can tell this with a specific example. You are saying that I know Koha. You cannot say simply like that, I know Koha. Because Koha consists of both installation as well as working knowledge. So what kind of knowledge you have in Koha? Whether you know how to install from the scratch? If I give a computer, can you be able to install it? No sir, I don't know that. I know only working. That means you should know. You should specify it clearly. I have working knowledge of Koha. I don't know how to install it. That's what you should specify clearly. Similarly, in your resume also you should write like that. If you know Koha, means I am having working knowledge, I am having installation knowledge. If you are writing simply Koha, means they will assume that you know both. You know how to install. Installating Koha means that you should know about the supporting softwares like Apache, SQL and everything you should know. Okay. If you don't know, you can clearly specify, I know only the working knowledge. After installing, I know how to use it. That is different. But how to install, I don't know. So you need to specify. Similarly, in this is the 39.50, if someone is talking about, you need to know whether it's client or server or both. So you need to specify. Okay. So this is the various terminologies and their differences. Okay. So what is IZET and what is IZET not? We will see with a comparison. So IZET is a computer to computer protocol. As I told you earlier, it is a communication language or communication link between one computer to another computer. It is not a database language. It is not a database of language, right? It is a language for communication. It is not a search engine. It is not Google actually. It is not Google. It is a language for communication that searches Google. Simple. It is not search engine. Search engine is Google. HR 39.50 is not a Google. Okay. A mechanism to search multiple databases at the same time. Okay. It is a mechanism to search multiple databases like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. And it is not a search command. The command is different. It forms a mechanism. It follows a procedure to retrieve results from different databases in the same time. Instead of searching the same query in the Google, Yahoo, and Bing separately, you can search the query one time, you can search it. So that is what it provides. It does not provide commands for such. Okay. A mechanism to retrieve records and have them displayed if they were on a local system. It is not a client interface, actually. It is not a client interface. It is a mechanism. It is a mechanism that displays local record, that displays retrieved results if there is a local system. Okay. It is not a client database. Okay. So what actually is that, how is a 39.50 will be helpful for your library? How this can be helpful? Now, based on the explanations I gave you, you might have been understood now how it can be helpful. See, if I want to search the books of various libraries, I can search it from single platform, right? So this protocol is helping me to do that, right? So it enables a single interface for information retrieval. See, it enables a single interface. So I want to search books from IIT library. So for example, this happens when this is useful when the university is having constituent colleges. That means I don't know whether you have heard about constituent colleges or not. Every university is having affiliated colleges. They call it as affiliated colleges. Let us take any university, state university, not central. I am talking about state university. Let's take Bihar University or Madras University or whatever state university it is. So there will be affiliating colleges. Though you study in any colleges, but you will get the degree from Bihar University only. Okay. You might not directly study from Bihar University. You might study something. So, for example, I am in Chennai, but I am not studying in Madras University, but I am studying in a college. Let's say Madras Christian. I am studying in Madras Christian College. But after completing my degree of BA or BSc, whatever it is, I will get the degree from Madras University only, not from Madras Christian College, MCC. So I hope you understood the difference. So the affiliated authority is Madras University. The affiliated college is Madras Christian College. So there are lots of colleges. So one state university might have more than 100 colleges. In Madras, I think there is more than 110 or 120 affiliated colleges, right? Madras University, under Madras University. So these 120 colleges, so the libraries of all the every colleges will have separate library, right? So, in order to search all the whole collections of Madras University and its affiliated colleges, unless you have HR 39.50, it is difficult. So, it comes very useful for those kind of universities and colleges, right? So, sitting in Madras Christian College library, I can search all the affiliated, all the resources of other affiliated colleges which are affiliated to Madras University, right? I can search the research of YMCA or all, whatever it is. Okay, whatever colleges. Loyola College or whatever college which comes under Madras University using a single search interface, or else I have to go back to that separate college website and search again. So this provides a single interface for information retrieval. See how it helpful for libraries. Choose a client carefully. Enable access to multiple diverse databases, not just online library databases. It gives access to multiple databases, not just online. Suppose simple and sophisticated searching. What do you mean by simple and sophisticated searching? Let us assume that the user have no knowledge how to search. He is just typing a keyword. That is simple. Based on a keyword, you are getting results. That is sophisticated, comfortable, right? Allows flexible and customizable retrieval. It allows flexible and customizable retrieval based on certain filters and parameters. So these are the opportunities. What are the benefits? Patron will have easier access to information outside of the local library. That is what I gave you an example about Madras University library and its affiliated colleges. I am sitting in MCC college library, I can access all the affiliated resources, all the resources of affiliated libraries, right? Because I am outside Madras University, but still I can access it using this protocol. Access is given to multiple databases using one interface, same. Single search, within a single search, I am searching all the databases. Can easily create a union catalog. I know in the last time I taught you about union catalog. It's combining more than one catalog, right? So you can easily create a union catalog if you are having a database of more than one library. Simple. What are the challenges? with sophistication comes complexity. There are the process is complex. Reserve 39 is misunderstood and invisible to most users. That is true. Whatever, because most of the people doesn't clearly understand what Reserve 39 is actually and what it can do for your library. Because this is very important. If you misunderstood this, you will not be able to understand what it actually does. Okay. Unrealistic expectations. So this is what it does. If you are having unrealistic expectation that everything should be in my fingertip, that is not possible. There are certain restrictions and there are certain limitations. Okay. So you should first understand what is a 39.50 is actually is. Then you should understand what role it performs and how it can be helpful for your library. If you are having unrealistic expectations without knowing what it can do, then you will end up in disappointment. So differences in implementation. So these are some of the challenges and drawbacks in the sense that what do you call disadvantages. Cost. So there are certain instances the cost might be a problem. Complexity for configuration, understanding of both the library database and services needed. For complexity means it's complex in nature. For example, you need to understand how the library client and how the database and how the server works. You need to have a basic knowledge for implementing this. Okay. You need to have a knowledge, then only you can implement. Unless having this knowledge, you will find it difficult. So what is this, man? I will ask it. Increased visibility and use. Okay, these are some of the drawbacks. Okay. So what? How does Reserve do it? So I'm going to explain this in a nutshell. So Reserve 39.50 is a standard way of submitting requests for information. Simple. I told you, right? It is a computer to computer protocol. So there is a standard way. So for example, I will give you a simple example. While writing letters, we can talk informally, but if you want to ask some request or something like leave or something, there is a form, right? So you have to fill up the leave form. Sir, I am leave from 1 week, or a leave letter. So that is a standard way of writing. You cannot just call me and say, sir, I need leave. So if you are writing to HOD or something, sir, from this week to this week, I am on leave. So please grant me permission. That is a standard way. So Reserve 39.5 is a standard way, not just a simple way. There is a standard way for submitting requests for information. It separates the client interface from the formal structure of the service. So that it separates. There is a formal structure, the client is separated from that particular structure. As long as the client and server understand each other, the information retrieval can easily occur. So the client and server should follow same language. Okay. If I am talking to Abhilash, means I should learn Malayalam, or he should learn Hindi, or we both should know English. Then only we can understand. If I am the client, he is the server, means if I am talking in English, he only knows Malayalam, means the information retrieval will be bad. Okay, the communication will be bad. So there should be a common link language. That is where Reserve 39.50 comes into play. It provides a standard for both client as well as servers, right? It designates what is a simple information request. It designates certain steps in interchange between client, that is the origin, and the server, that is the target. Okay, client origin and the target. Okay, so there are certain steps. We saw how information is passed from origin to target, right? So there are certain steps, just not taking and giving it. Just there are certain protocols to be followed. That is a 39.50 designate how it has to be done. These steps are known as services. These kind of steps are called services. These services are required to be supported and others are provided. So we will see what are these services actually. So what are the required services? The first service is INIT, initialization. Initialization is establishes a IZET association. That is means a connection. So I am talking. For example, I am talking in English, but Abhilash knows only Malayalam. So what this IZET does actually, it converts my English into Malayalam and provides translation to him. It establishes a connection, INIT. Okay, automatically it does that. So when a user searches a query, automatically it converts into INIT and it establishes a connection between client origin and the target. Okay. And search, what is search? We all know what is search is. Allowing a client to query a database, not the user, client. Client is querying a database. Client is searching the database, like Google, Yahoo server. We have submitted our request. Now the client is going to search the database. Present is retrieving the results. The client is asking the server to provide information matching the search query. Okay, I have searched for public library. Now I have asked for, I have requested for public library, and int is generalized to establish a z association, and now client is going to search the database, right? So database, that is search part, and the present part is it is asking the server. So please, the user has asked for information, public library. So please find information related to public library and send it back to me. I will send it to the user. So this part is called the present. These are the services. These steps are called as services. Okay. So these are the required. Required means these are essential. So there are other services like delete, sort, scan, and close. So these are depending upon the nature of the query, right? So let's see this. Let's see this with a simple example. Okay. So see, send an IN90 request to the server. Okay, so someone is requesting information, the EZ association is formed. The client and the server agree upon certain parameter that will be in effect for the duration of the association. The IN90 is, there is a agreement between client and server. I am searching the database, I am the user, I am typing public library in my called Google search engine. Now the client and server will establish a common language. That common language is called as EZ39.50. That common language association is established by this service IN90 initialization. Okay. So next, what is the next procedure? The server respond with the result parameter. Value of accept if okay, reject if not. So the result is searched. If it is related to public library, it will accept okay. If it is not related to public library, it will reject it. It will not provide, it will not present the result. So next, the client sends a search request. The request includes query, type, and other information. The servers respond with the number of records but not the information request. Okay. So after the search request sent by the client to the server, it presents the number of records. So these many records are available. Nearly 1 lakh records are available related to public library. So the client sends a present request. The client, what it does that, it presents the results, and then the server responds with the information requested in the search. Okay, so this is how the process works of searching and retrieving. So see, this is the composition of a query. See this example. The patron has no knowledge of this composition. Okay, the patron, that means the user. Patron is a user. Okay, the user doesn't know how EZ39.50 actually works. That is true. Okay, because this works everything in the backend. He is typing something in the Google search engine, he is typing something in the library database, he is getting results. Simple for him, it's simple, but the backend process is like this. So the patron enter information required by the client. The client composes EZ39.50 search query. Whatever the information requested by the patron or the user, it is composed into EZ39.50 by the client. The client composes, because the client and the server agrees on certain parameters. They are having a link language. That link language is EZ39.50. The patron may have only access to enter a name and click. Patron is what the user is, what is he doing is, he is just typing the keyword. What is the keyword? Author, click author and search. In the author tab, in the OPAC, let's say whatever it may be, let's take a library catalog. OPAC is typing author tab and clicking, searching for author Mark Twain, Twain Mark. So he's typing that only. When the user is typing that only, the information is requested that only. Now it is the work of the client, server, target, origin to fetch the information from the databases and give the results back to the user. So based on this, the client will specify bib1 attribute set. What is bib1? Because author is a bibliographical entry, right? So bib1 is an attribute of EZ39.50. There are different attributes. I am not going to explain each and every attribute, and it is not possible also. I am giving a specific example so that you can understand. So bib1 attribute is related to bibliographical details, right? Like author, title, keyword, ISBN. Okay, so since this is a bibliographical detail, so EZ39.50 specified to bib1 attribute. So attributes characterize the search term and the relationship. Okay, so there are relationship between these attributes. Okay, they are characterized. Okay, let's see how this is. So these are the different BibOne attributes. Use, relation, structure, truncation, and others are there. We will see position is there, and we will see what there are. See, the author has typed only Mark Twain, right? See how the translation, how the IZ 39.50 translated according to their communication. So 1 is equal to 1003, 2 is equal to 3, 4 is equal to 1, 5 is equal to 100. So we don't know what is this, right? So what is these numbers represent actually? So this is the communication between client and the server using IZ 39.50 protocol. So I will show you this example, okay? So these are the BIB is bibliographical details or something, okay? That BIB has a BIB types and values. What are the types? There are, you see, there are 6 attributes in bibliographical type, right? What are they? Use is the value of use is 1, value of relation is 2, position is 3, structure is 4, truncation is 5, completeness is 6. And you see this. These are bibliographical types and values. There are many. I have not taken everything. If you go to this particular website, you will find all the bibliographical attributes. This is use attribute. You see for author, the code language is 1003. Author, you see it here. Our author is 1003. So that's why you see one is use. They have used author field. Mark Twain is author, right? So they have used author field. The author for the value for author according to IZ 39.50 use field is BIB field is 1003. So this is how they convert the language, right? So this 1003, we don't know what is it unless we see the table, right? So this is the link language for them. Okay, this is one. So one is used. They are using author field and they are typing the name of the author. So author field falls into the use of use is one. The author fields falls into 1003 attribute. So first is finished. So what is this 2 and what is this 3? We will see it. 2 is the relation. 2 is the relation attribute. What is the relation? You should match the relation equal to. So here you see the relation attributes. C is 3 is equal to relation. So exactly you should bring it. Whatever I am using there, whatever I am typing it, I need the exact equal relation. So that is why they are using the relation equal to. Here 2 is equal to 3. 2 is the relation attribute and 3 is the equal attribute based on the relation attribute, right? 3 is the sub value. So now 4 is equal to 1. What is 4? 4 is the structure. What is the structure? What is the structure of my search? What is the structure of my search? I have the user has searched Twain Mark. Twain Mark is, there is, you see, double quotes are there. Double quotes means phrase is search. The structure of my search is phrase is search. So for the phrased value, you need to go again to see the structure attribute. See, phrase, it is not a word. It is a phrase because there is double quotes, right? So that means it takes it into the phrase attribute. That is 1. So 4 is the structure of the query, the structure of the information requested is 4. The relation is equal to, that means equal result I want. Okay, next is the any truncation. Truncation means do not truncate. Here it takes 100. 100 means do not truncate. You have to come to the truncation attribute. You see 100, do not truncate. Truncate means, I know in search strategies you might have heard. Truncation means if there are some missing words like M-A-R. Or MAR, if I type a star, means it will bring all the related words, Mark, Mars, whatever it is. So because the term is clear, Mark Twain is clear. So no need to truncate it. So I can present the term as it is. So for not needing to truncate, do not truncate means it is 100. If I need truncate left or right means it is 1 or 2. So I am not going, though the computer is not going to truncate it. So this is how the translation is done using IZ 39.50 for a single query, that too for Mark Twain. See if there is a long title, how it goes, right? I have given a specific example. So you please go through this particular website to see the full details. This is only a short number of details because I want to show you the 1000. I took this field only, this parameter only. So these are different kinds of, there are different attributes, okay? So this is how the translation is made. This we don't know, we won't see it because everything is happening in the back end, that too in a fraction of a second. So this is why IZ 39.50 is essential, okay, for library, is to communicate in a single language, that too across multiple databases, okay? I hope you understand. Please go through this once again. So coming to the end part of this session, so as I said earlier, what IZ 39.50 does is, right? Provides a single interface single interface for accessing multiple servers. Okay. It provides exchange of information such as surrogates of records, surrogate records. I told you what is surrogate. It's like a duplicating representative or substituting of full text between otherwise non-compatible system. See, some system may be have non-compatibility because of this translation in ISO 39.50, it forms a uniform procedure. Simple as that. So what are the advantages? Primary advantages is the cost. Some ILS software does the searching for you. They may charge a fee for enabling this service. There are softwares, private library management softwares. They have this facility, but they will come with fees, extra fees or something like that. The disadvantage is you might have to search each library individually. Although there are some ILAs that will let you search a handful or so at a time. Okay. So these are some of the advantages and disadvantages. We saw that earlier in challenges, opportunities, threats, like. So this is all about this is the 39.50 protocol and its usage in library. So kindly go through these references on the website I showed you, because that will help you for better understanding. This is the resources that is used to present this PPT. So thank you.